All right, guys, we're at the track, and I'm just leaving, but I wanted to do a review, a 5,400-mile review on the GS. I got very little to complain about. There's just three issues with the bike, and the two of them are just pet peeves. I think they should have put an adjustable electronic windscreen and a heated seat. Maybe their next, maybe like a GS 1300 or 1300 GS might have those upgrades. Maybe a little more power, although you don't really need it. But so that's just the two ones. I'll get to the other one in a little bit. I just want to talk about the bike and what I feel about this bike is just, I'm going to do a little video. I'm a little off track here. I did a video of just a walk around just to show you what little things I've done to the bike. And I'll put this right after this in the middle of this video or something like that. And we can talk about, with the trial, talk about what I like about this bike. And pretty much this bike has pretty much met every single one of my expectations. It's a do-it-all bike. I mean, this bike does everything I need. When I first looked at it, I said this before in the videos, you know, it's kind of cool, but, you know, is this something, you know, I don't know, maybe just not my cup of tea. Took it for a test ride. Absolutely fell in love with the ride. The looks have really grown on me. I really like the bike. I do love cruisers. I love the way they look, but they're just not comfortable. I mean, for like an all-day experience, for me anyway, everybody's different. Some guys like the big cruisers. You know, the baggers and stuff. Not for me. This is everything I ask it to do. It's got plenty of power. I have not an issue with any sport bike for me so far from 0 to 100. I mean, over 100, they're going to walk me, yeah. But 0 to 100 is fine for me. You know, when I get to 120, 130, that's enough for me. I don't need to be going 180. That's big enough thrill for me. So this bike does everything from 0 to 100. It does it all. It's fast. I mean, I can't even keep the front wheel down. I put it in like the wheelie control, a different modes. You can set them in different ways. And I have it so it does very little, you know, wheel stands. And it works out good for me anyway. So, yeah. So the bike is just, it's like a Swiss Army knife. And I've said that before. It just does everything. And, you know, as people, it's a jack of all trades, but it does everything well. I mean, it handles so well. I'm just so impressed with the handling of this bike. I mean, you just flip it. Oh, no problem. I mean, I don't have the skill level even to push this to its max. You know, I mostly ride in road mode, but, you know, if it gets really twisty and smooth, I'll put it in a dynamic. But it's just so smooth. And it just goes where you want it to go. You know, it's a funny statement. Everybody says it goes where you want. Of course, it goes where you want to go. But you're so confident in it. You're so confident in leaning this a bike at high speed. You know you're not going to get in trouble. I'm not saying you can't, but your confidence is very, very high. Low speed maneuverability, it's super. I looked at some reviews. People say it's kind of big and stuff. I guess if you're short, it's a problem. You know, I'm 5'11", 32-inch inseam. I don't have any problem in tight maneuvers, lane splitting. I find it absolutely a joy. I don't find this bike big at all. And that's what I love about the bike so much. It's big enough, I guess, for the highway. It's so comfortable. I feel like I'm in a solid big car on the highway. I feel totally secure, yet I can hit the twisties. I can go through the city. And like I said, it does it all. You know. And to some, I'm sure I'm just preaching to the choir where this is what they believe. Others, you know, others call it an old man bike, or, you know, one of the bloggers said, you know, because I wanted to go cross country or something, and he's got a Ducati Monster, and it's a standard naked bike. I don't know how he does it, but he goes everywhere with it. He says, I'm cheating with this one because it just rides so nice. It's so smooth. I'm going over railroad tracks. I don't even have to stand up on these things. I don't feel that at all. I mean, you might see that I'm moving around, but it's not jarring. whatsoever. So overall ride and quality, of, I mean, as far as ride quality and handling and everything like that, super. Power. It's just fucking there. It's just, it's effortless. It's, so it's got great power, maneuverability, everything. Now, as far as quality control, I guess, how the bike is built and everything like that, I've got 5,000 miles on it. I'm not saying I'm a hard rider, but, you know, I ride it pretty good. Not one single issue with this bike. Nothing. A friend of mine, Joe, has a GSA. He's had starting issues, and he had a problem with the drive. But it was fixed. He still loves the bike because even with the issues, I've had none of those issues. I've had nothing. The bike has been absolutely super, super dependable. Oh, it's like we have a nice get together over here. Nice. And it's been totally reliable. Absolutely totally reliable. Tire wear looks great. I mean, my dealer told me that the service department said, you know, 6,500, we like to do the next service, and then you might need tires by then. But I think I'm going to be able to get 8,000 out of these. But we'll see. And so quality, nothing's fallen off. Nothing's broken. It's great. I know it's an expensive bike, and I think it's worth every single penny. I did mention you'll see that when I talk about what I put on. I put on these grip puppies. They kind of wear out after a couple months, but I really like them, and they're cheap, and I just replace them every couple of months. But that's not BMW stuff. Like I said, nothing is broken. Everything is quality. The way the wires are run, when I put on Denali lights, everything underneath the bike is just, everything is good. So very happy with quality. I think if somebody's interested in a bike like this, you can't go wrong. I don't know how the Triumphs are. I don't know how the KTMs are. I know people that have them love the KTM. Lots of power. Ducati Multistrada, lots of power. I think they were too sporty for me. I really want a cushy ride when I want one. And nice bikes. And this just has a super cushy ride when I want it, and sporty when I want it also, just with a push of a button. So I'm really liking that. And so let's see, what else can we talk about the bike after so many miles? And it's not a lot of miles, but you know, the way I'm riding now, I'm going to easily have 10,000 by the end of the year. I mean, I don't put the bike away. I ride in the winter too. So, and then I'm going to be moving to North Carolina, so there's going to be no times that I'm going to be stopping. Let's see. I've driven it at night in the rain, no problems. It's very comfortable, very secure. You don't feel uncomfortable at all. That's another thing too. I guess I've mentioned it. You're on the highway. I'm doing 75. I'm next to a car. I look at him. I feel totally secure. One hand, I can rest it on the tank. I feel the bike is extremely stable. Extremely stable. Just, I can, no hands, no problem. I mean, I put the cruise on. I mean, this bike is just beautiful. It's so stable. Now, my Triumph, once in a while, I'll get a little bit of wobble. I don't know if it's because the tire's worn out or not. But this, I could sit here forever like this. It's just, I mean, like this, you're tired. It's super. So, as far as I'm concerned, you can't go wrong. I guess I'm repeating myself. This is a great buy for the money. I know Joe spent a little bit more money than me on his GSA, but he's got a ton more stuff on the bike. I didn't want the really big tank, even though that's great for going for long distance. You know, this will go, whatever, 220 miles, 250 miles. I'm good with that, with the 5-gallon tank. I love the way it looks now. Like I said, the looks have really grown on me. I always look forward to riding this bike. And I'm sure you guys are waiting for my one dislike about the bike and one disappointment about the bike. And basically it is when it's warm. When you start the bike up, it's got a nice boxer sound, nice boxer exhaust. I'm happy with the exhaust. I don't want something that drones, so I'm very happy with the exhaust. Even when you open it up, it's not as loud as my Triumph, but it's fine. But as soon as the bike warms up, and I guess the oil gets thin, the engine just sounds like crap. I'm sorry, guys. It just sounds like shit. It sounds like an old muscle car from the 60s with a solid lifter valve train that you have to adjust, and it sounds like it's out of adjustment. Just clackety-clack, clack, clack, clack. I was told by the dealer, told by service, it's normal. My buddy's Joe's GSA makes the same noise. It's more pronounced. It seems like it's on the left side than the right side. But, you know, that's the only thing I wish they would do. I mean, you know, after a long ride, you pull up to a light or your buddy, and he's saying, what the fuck is wrong with your bike? I said, that's just the way they sound. And so that's a kind of a disappointment. That's my only disappointment. But, you know, when I'm cruising, I don't hear that. You don't hear that. There's no valve train issues when you're, you know, when you're above 3,000 or 2,500. Now, I'm in sixth gear right now, going 35 or 39. You don't have to be in sixth. But, you know, so that's my biggest disappointment. I just wish it would have a nicer sound. Like my Triumph sounds great at an idle or when you rev it up. And this one just, I wish BMW could do something about that. Like I said, they said, no, there's no issues with it as far as damage or anything, but I'm not worried. I got the warranty. But, you know, I don't know if it's that because of the shift cam or what the issue is, but... And so that's it. That's my only disappointment with the bike. Otherwise, the bike, I love the bike. I'll deal with that issue. I'm okay with it. Some people it doesn't bother, but you know, I like the bike to be, you know, at an idle, like just like this here in the engine. I don't want to hear, you know, clackety clack 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 clack. So I guess that's my review. Total, you know, 5-star review. I guess maybe you could say 4.75 stars because. You know, just that engine issue because of the noise, not because of the performance. You know, look at that. I don't know if you guys can see this. Hopefully you can see it on the camera. That's Genesee. That's the town of Genesee. It's just beautiful out here. It's absolutely gorgeous. It's just beautiful. It's 84 degrees and, you know, nothing but farmland. I'm just having such a good time. I could ride like this forever. You know, I guess I've mentioned that. I can ride like this. This bike is, I can't wait for my long trip. I'm just dying. Tomorrow we're going to Niagara Falls with my buddy. So hopefully I can tape that and you guys can check that out. We'll be on our headsets and we can be bullshitting each other. Two other guys, they won't be on the headset, so we'll just make fun of them. My buddy will be taking my Triumph and... his buddies, I guess they got Harleys, you know. Everybody's a Harley guy, you know. I never wanted a Harley because everybody's got them. I'm not saying they're not good bikes. They're great bikes, but I love the Breakout. The Breakout's one of my favorite looking bikes. But this is the baby. This does it all. It may not be the coolest when it comes to the biker crowd, but it does it all. I know I sound like a broken record. I can't say enough about this. I don't know what the Triumph ride's like. I don't know what the Ducati ride's like. I don't know what the KTM ride's like. I don't know if it's the same thing or not. But there must be a lot of parties out here today. Nice. Oh, I love to see get-togethers. Life back to normal. No fucking mask. I love it. Oh, I love you, upstate New York. Well, western New York. We're like a little south of Rochester. So I don't know what those bikes ride like. But... This is just, so put in the comments, or if you want, with the few views that I get, and tell me if you agree with me, or tell me if I'm full of shit. You just, because you bought it, you're going to praise it. I'll tell you about my Triumph. I love the way it sounds. I love the way it handles. I scrape the boards all the time, because this one, I haven't come close to scraping anything. But when you get up on highway speed, it's not as comfortable. It doesn't, when you hit the bumps, one hard bump, even with my good seat on it, I'm done for the day. It's more of just a town bike, just cruising to the bar or wherever you want to go, get ice cream. That's it for me. That's all it is for me. And you know, and when you get into the RPMs, the higher RPMs, like 62, it's pretty nuts. And you feel a little bit of vibration, where I don't feel shit on this bike. So the Triumph is not a perfect bike, and I spent good money on it. I love the way it looks. I just love the styling. I hope to never get rid of that bike.
All right, guys. So I've added a lot of little things to the bike, but let's get to the foot pegs. I didn't like the factory foot pegs. Just not my cup of tea. They were too narrow and a little bit too high. So these are by SW Motec and quality product. And I got them through Revzilla. excellent price. Most of the times I seen them, they were like 190, and I got them for 130. At first, they just sent me the peg itself, and they didn't send me the adapter. And I said, okay, well, that's why it was so cheap. And then a week later, I got the adapter. So that was pretty cool. It's really nice, very well made. And this I showed you before in my other video. I think it was a 2,000 mile review. And it just bolts onto the. It's too small. I want something that I can just hit the brake, back brake when I'm going real slow. So, and that's just something made in China. I bought on Amazon. So, and you guys have seen the Motec crash bars. Some people say I should get the ones up here, but I don't really not want them. I don't really come off road with this thing. I mean, this is the biggest off road I've been on this bike. So they're real nice. I did put the splash guard. Now I kind of forget who that was by. It probably says it right on it. I can't really see it, but you guys can see it. The name's right there. So that was nice. It keeps everything nice and clean over here. So, and I put on these grips. You guys know, this is my second set. They don't last long, a couple months, but they're really nice. They're grip puppies. I like them. And let's see, what else do we do? Okay, so these are new. I went with the Denalis. I think they're pretty cool. And I love the way they work. You know, when you flash the high beams, they flash real quick. And then when you put on the four ways, they flash on and off. But you can put them bright, dim. It's just a cool setup. And it's all plug and play. The hardest thing to do is try to figure out, the place to route the wires. But that's pretty easy. It's not bad. It's not bad at all. So, whoops. Here we go. And what else? Oh yeah, I guess you can't really see it, but I might go with those, Joe, I'm sure you might be watching this or not. Maybe you are, maybe not. But you got the nice LED turn signals. It's a lot different, and they kind of work like the Denali stuff, where they can be amber, so they can look like driving lights, and then they can turn signals and stuff. But I just want ones you pop the bulb in. I don't know if you guys can see that or not. And I forget the brand also. I'll put it in the description. And they work great. I'm pretty happy. They're expensive. They're like $125 a piece, but I haven't had any issues with them. But they're only amber, so you can't change anything. So whatever, it's just amber. But they're bright. And let's see, what else did I have done? That's about probably it. I guess you guys have seen these. It's just my brackets for RAM brackets for my phone. My GoPro and my 360 camera, and then I think I already talked about this. Another SW Motec, and excellent. The quality is excellent. It was expensive, but it was well worth the money because I needed more room from here, from here to here, and that was nice. And now it's more. This is more of a little bit of an angle this way, so it's just perfect. It's really fits me perfect. And let's see, what else did we do? Oh, yeah, I forgot about that. I have to go back to the front, but let me show you what we did here. So there's no shadow on here. I put on the Denali brake light license plate. This is really nice. So when you hit the brakes, it flashes real quick and then goes solid red. And so you can be seen. I also put these, going brain dead. But you've seen them on tractor trailers and stuff like that. Just reflective tape. Really works nice to light up the back of my bike. And let's go back to the front real quick and just show you what I did. I put one of their horns on. It's a sound bomb, but it's not the air horn. I didn't want to go with the air horn. I just wanted something that didn't sound like a roadrunner from the 1970s, late 60s. So it's got a nice car sound horn, nice and loud. Hey, I guess that's it. That's the bike, and I got 5,400 miles on it. Absolutely loving it, and you'll hear more in the video when I'm riding, and I'll tell you what the good points are and what the bad points are. But overall, the bike is just, I love the way the bike looks. I said this many times, I really didn't go to buy a bike like this because, I don't know, it's just, I love the cruiser bikes, but they don't ride and handle like this. I can ride this thing all day long. I'm never fatigued on this bike, so... So there it is, folks. We're at the racetrack. I'm doing my review, my 5,400 mile review, and we'll hop back on the bike and we'll talk more about it.
So, I'm definitely a fanboy, and this is the bike. I can see myself getting another one. If BMW comes up with a R1300 GS with the upgraded, maybe a better seat. Now, seat comfort is, I have no problem with. I'm talking about a heated seat. Some people change it right away. I love the seat. I've been in the rain. It dries like that. It's comfortable. It's very durable. I don't have to worry about ripping or anything like that. But if they come up with a heated seat, electronic windscreen, and, you know, maybe a little more power, call it the 1300, I'll be buying another one. The windscreen. I didn't talk about that. We'll finish up on the windscreen. I'm in the upper position. When I came to the racetrack here, it was hot. I had the lower position so I could get a little more air, which was fine. But some people complain about it. Now, right now, it is hitting my shoulders, but not hard. Over here is just kind of, you feel a little breeze, but it's not pushing you or anything like that. It's kind of like a dead area. Some people don't like it. They said, I'm 5'11", and I'm getting no buffeting on the head whatsoever. I mean, if I go like that, I feel it sit like this, none. When wintertime comes, I may put the GSA one, which is a little bit wider and it's a little bit taller, or go with an aftermarket. I'm sure. I think I want to go with the stock, the BMW ones. Joe said it's a pretty good one, even though he went with a bigger one because he felt he needed more. I'm totally happy with it. So I know people are complaining about it, but I'm absolutely happy with the windscreen. The mirrors, they're funky looking, but my God, I can see both sides of the street from either one. So I can see that side of the street in this mirror. I can see that side of the street in this mirror. Beautiful. You know, you feel like you're in a 4x4. You feel like you got great view, visibility. Everything is great. But how can a 4x4 handle like this? How can a 4x4 accelerate like this? I don't know how they did it. Now, I can't imagine what a KTM is like. Now, here we're coming on a pretty good bump. I might stand up because it's a pretty good bump. But it easily handles it. But the KTM, I heard, is fast. But I like the idea of the drive shaft instead of a chain, just less maintenance and stuff like that. And you know, with the Triumph 1200, you get the drive shaft, and then the KTM and the Ducati have the chain. So, but I like the way the Ducati looks. To be honest with you, I love the silver and red one. I love that one. But and that's the bike I was going to look at. Until I took this for a test ride, so. All right, so that's my review. All thumbs up on everything. Love the bike. If you don't like it, let me know. Hopefully I'll have that video tomorrow from Niagara Falls. That'd be cool, right? Show you the falls and, you know, never been there, so it should be fun. All right, guys, later.